Welcome back to The Breakfast on PLUS TV Africa. Now, open grazing will no longer be allowed in southern Nigeria. That's one of the decisions reached at a meeting of the governors of the southern region in Asaba yesterday. The governors say it's to check the incursion of armed herders, criminals and bandits into the southern part of the country. They also decided that it's time for President Muhammadu Buhari to address the nation on the security challenges in Nigeria. Public affairs analyst Mr. Alester Wilcox is joining us this morning. Good morning, Mr. Wilcox.
Good morning, the ABLE crew, and thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. All right, we know that about 17 or southern governors met in Asaba yesterday to discuss crucial matters, and that was happening even as, you know, the president was meeting with service chiefs in Abuja yesterday as well. So talking about, you know, one of the fallouts of the discussion, you know, in Asaba, they said that, you know, open grazing would be banned in the southern states. Talking about that, we know that time and time again, southern governors have been asking and even declaring that open grazing would be banned. But really, is that the way forward regarding the herdsmen crisis that we've been seeing in the country?
Thank you. I don't have all the facts as to the, this just came, I also had it from the news yesterday. I don't have all the facts, the intelligence, the intels, and all the issues that the governors had at their disposal to come up with such a joint decision. So I believe that they must have reviewed every fact and the information at their disposal for them to collectively come to that decision. Is that the way forward? Well, I will adopt a wait-and-see approach as to the modalities of how it's going to be implemented. Right now, it is a joint decision. Every state needs to go back to their states and through their state assemblies enact the enable environment legislation. For instance, I know that some time ago, under Fayose as governor of Ekiti, he enacted that law on is it open on ninth grazing? I can't remember which of them. On those states, has I think had a similar legislation in that respect. So when the whole issues are clear on the ground and the alternatives that are preferred are there, then we can now begin to know if it's the way forward or not the way. I think at this point it's rather premature to judge the actions of the governors. But whatever the governors are doing, I believe they have adequate intel, they have adequate intelligence, they have adequate facts, and they must have looked at the overall national interest in whatever thing they are doing.
All right. There's also something they mentioned there with regards restructuring, and of course asking that the president speaks with the country. Can you quickly react to those two?
Well, I'm not a fan of those who call the president always talk. Yesterday, the president was speaking with service chiefs, and the third meeting in about 3 weeks, so to say, the president was doing that, and the president was discussing with the group, with the service chiefs, and everybody, they come up with solutions and all ideas and all what. And one of the things they said is they are not going to disclose anymore the strategies being adopted by the security agencies in curbing some of these national crime, national security challenges. Asking the president to speak to the nations, I am not a fan of it. If he wants to, that is his responsibility. I don't do that call, and I will not do it at this point in time. Talking about restructuring, we have dwelt too much on that ground. And even yesterday, I traveled yesterday, and in the facility we are traveling, that was one of the discussions we are having, very heated one. Up to today, I think I'm yet to get a proper definition of restructuring. If all right now we keep saying devolve power, devolve power, devolve power, the question I ask, the amount of power already devolved, what has been used for? What other restructuring are we looking for? Is it only resource control and restructuring? Because if you ask 10 people about restructuring, they tell you resource control and all that. So I'm not I don't want to join that fray, but sincerely, I'm not a fan of all those noise. We can work better with what we have. What we have today, if we work with it, I'm not sure we have any issues within states, within development, within providing for the masses. So that's my take.
All right. Mr. Wilcox, going back to the issue of this open grazing, I need to mention that beyond all the fallouts, including, you know, farmers' headers crisis, the clashes, how they both, you know, pull out their swords and begin to fight each other, beyond that, you know, challenge with open grazing, there are other factors we need to consider. We know that experts have warned about the dangers of desertification and about, you know, when these cows graze and how they destroy crops and how that affects food security in Nigeria. So even if we're not looking at it from the loss, the irreplaceable loss to human life, looking at it from the aspect of how it threatens food security, would you say that, you know, the decision of the Southern governors to ban open grazing is a commendable one?
I'm not commending any of the decisions. Well, first and foremost, I want to even be happy that the Southern governors have finally found their feet, because I can't remember the last time the Southern governors had their have met. They used to have a regular meeting in time past, during the from 1999 to about 2003, 2005. They used to have regular meetings and all that. Because I'm happy they are back. They're trying to also galvanize position. I'm not commending the effort. Sincerely, there is too many sides to it, and almost most of the time we look at the negatives. I know that farmer headers clashes has always been a recurrent decimal all over the country, in the country, sometimes over exaggerated. Today, every crime committed in Nigeria is attributed to herdsmen and all whatnot, and giving the real criminals a getaway car to run, to keep perpetrating their act. Today, some of the worst security challenges we're having today is because we have profiled crimes to a particular tribe, particular people, and so every crime is attributed to them. I'm not in that school of thought, and I think the Southern governors understand this fact very, very well. The issue of grazing is an issue. Now, if you are banning open grazing, what is the alternative? I will say we don't want cows in the south of Nigeria any longer. Let's be clear on that. If we want cows, what are the distinct? First, they made the idea of Ruger, and everybody kicked against it. They say, oh, some people want to grab land and all that. We talk about ranching. Has any of the governors of this state been able to provide enough facility for there to be adequate ranching? I think Bayelsa State government tried to do something there's a place they call Plantation in Bayelsa State, that they try to do something, providing a lot of facility there. I don't know how they extend that. That's during Governor Dixon's reign as governor. I don't know how extend that went. Has there been alternatives? Is it just to come on the piece of paper and play populism and shout and incite the people against each other? What is the alternative?
But we know that Governor Governor Akeredolu.
Go ahead, Mr.
Wilcox.
What about food security?
Go ahead, Mr. Wilcox. We can hear you, yes.
Yeah, we're talking about food security. What are the other actions that we do down south that threaten the real food security? Today, the activities, do we even consider the activities of land speculators in taking away most of the lands of the small farmers in places of wanting to build estate? Now, let me be explicit, and I've said that to you before. I don't know if it's on your own platform. Before now, from a place like Ajah to Ekpe, you have all kinds of manner of small farm holders, small farmers holding up to. But today, land speculators are taking all that area. They are all building one estate or the other. No more production of those basic little crops. We're not talking about that. Nobody talks about that. From Bega to Shagam, before, apart from the Din camp, now, before Muwe and all this come out, today, and let me just make this point. There used to be farming communities along that up to Shagam. Today, there is no one. It's not farmer headers clashing. So the activities of our economic activities, our other activities, are what is really threatening food security. And I can tell you that for free. So if we don't look at those areas, The population is widening up. The farming lands are thinning in because there is now urbanization in every area. Businesses are taking over. Churches are taking over lands. Religious are taking over lands. Camps everywhere. Estates that people are not inhibiting everywhere. These are the real threat to food security. Not just these herders only. Because most of them, where they graze bushes. I'm not holding beef for them. I'm not a header. I've not been in their business before. But sometimes if I'm traveling, we see them grazing bushes. Once, yes, they stroll into farms, like in those farming communities, like in the interlands. They graze, and those places have been there. We must manage it and not attribute any problems to this particular set of people. That is wrong. That is not right. That is not fair, because we are not addressing the situation and we keep groping in that.
All right. So, I was just going to throw in finally, do you think the decisions of the resolutions of the southern governors should be one step towards a national order to ban open grazing across the whole country?
Yes, I will want open grazing to be banned. Like, we must progress. We must progress as a country. I want open grazing to be banned, but of course it has to be a phase ban. What is the alternative? Almost all agree on the alternative. Do we want to provide, if I'm a state governor, sincerely, like if I'm a state governor of River State, I'm from River State and president in Port Harcourt, if I'm a state governor of River State, I know where there are lands. If you are going through the east-west road, going towards Akwa Ibom, the vast land, I could set up a big ranch and make money. If you go to Ogun State has so much land asset that I don't know what they are doing with it. You can set up a big ranch. Same for your state. These are states that have big land assets that they could set up big ranches and make money out of it. But if they're not doing that and everybody's going to the gallery, it's a good decision, because we must progress. And cattle rearing must be a business. I have a friend in Lagos who rears cattle, although in a small quantity. He has a ranch, a little ranch. Also, once in a while, he takes the cattle out. He has a ranch for them. And then they are all there and they are growing. So this is a friend of mine in Lagos. So people, we must advance. The provision is increasing. The demand for protein, meat protein, is increasing by the day. And so there must be a serious solution, to not political solution, not ethnic, not ethnicizing anything, but seeing this thing as a problem that needs to be turned into a business. And except we do that, we'll be growing that and be setting ourselves against each other. Now, certain governors are taking a decision. What will be the response of northern governors? If they're not taking a decision that also will hurt the south, what will we do? We'll not start shouting. So we must be careful in what we do, so that we don't destroy the fragile national equation that we are existing right now. Let us see that we promote it rather than things that will shake it further.
All right, Mr. Wilcox, just to throw in some facts here, we know that the Ondo State Governor, has mentioned that he's taking ranching very seriously and he's reactivating some of the ranches in Ondo State. But other governors, like the Oyo State Governor, Shane Makinde, has said that ranching is a private business and he wouldn't be giving out state lands to private investors or private herders to do business. But it seems this is a conversation we'll continue to have for a long time, but we'll be glad to bring you in future to discuss this more.
Let me advise Governor Makinde that when there's a problem, you find a solution. And that solution does not mean grandstanding. That is why I'm saying business. If I'm a River State Governor today, I will do big business out of it. And so Oyo State that has vast land, you are not giving it out. You sell land. After they sell land to churches, they sell land to people that build schools. Then they sell land. So you sell land, or you develop it and make money out of it. My brother, that is the way we should go. Finally, I say God bless Nigeria, and may God protect our troops.
I believe they can also buy land in other states that are willing to sell to them. It's not, nobody can be forced to sell to them or convinced to sell to them. Alyssa Wilcox, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
All right. Short break when we come back. Still here on The Breakfast, it's World Facilities Management Day, and we're going to be having a conversation about that. In the space of a COVID-19 era, how do we move forward? We'll talk about it when we come back. Stick around.